welcome back to Farmer Simulator 22. Today we're back on Midwest Hills, running the TMR mixer feed cart over to the main farm. We're going to try to get some TMR out of the silos. We also have a pack of four-wheel drive tractors. FTL mods. These are based on the white Oliver Minneapolis-Moline Cockshutt series four-wheel drive tractors. Make sure we're on the right path here. We got our total mixed rations ready here. Basically just had to put silage and grass into the silos there and activate it. We'll go up ahead here. Our cow's moving around over there. Should be producing milk pretty soon here. Alright, so we're back here at the store, the tractor house. We have our lineup of four-wheel drive tractors here. We got Oliver 2655, Plainsman A4T-1600 white, 2655 Cockshutt turbo white, Minneapolis-Moline A4T-1600 turbo, another Minneapolis-Moline A4T-1600 turbo in red. You guys are probably wondering why we got all the similar models and different brands, but these were actually all under White Motor Company. White Motor Company owned Oliver Cockshutt and Minneapolis-Moline. We got a couple of these out in the field we're gonna use. We'll go out there. Alright, first we got our Minneapolis-Moline A4T-1600 turbo. There's a couple different There's a couple different motor options, the standard and the turboed. Their overhead lights, warning lights. The first time actually trying the four ways, just checking them out. I actually turned down the brightness of the flashers in the game. It's not so annoying. Also different tire options. I put the wide tires with weights all the way around on this one. See how it does pull in this chisel plow here. Right now these have the automatics in it, but FTL mods might actually do a second release with the manual transmissions. I believe he said 10 speed. I got a huge field of hay I did over there. I'll have to do that up sometime. See how it does pull on this up the hill here. Flashers on top are more like the old school ones. We're making this work pretty good. Try to match up the digger, etc. with the tractor horsepower. You've got the gauges working there. You can see the tachometer working there. I'd have to do a head roll sometime. Try to create a job for this. Right, so we'll see how this works. Actually, we're going to have to start him over a little bit. He's going to end up going back over. I should say she's gonna have to go back over some of this. That's all right. It seems like maps I've done lately, they always skip the outside row. Well, that's nothing new. We'll get back over to our other tractor. All right, we got our Oliver 2655 hooked up to the planter here. I was going to do a bigger planter, but it takes a lot more horsepower, so we got this here. It's the 1113 John Deere planter. We're going to do regular corn in both of these fields. I can do a straight line. About doing the markers, but they're way off from what the actual width of the planter is. I don't know if those are actually adjustable. We'll try that sometime when you guys aren't watching. The turbo version, we're at about 200 horsepower. So we've just got enough power to pull the planter up the hill here. Yeah. Yeah, see what this numb nuts is doing? Excuse my language. Yeah, he's gone off the reservation. Put this guy aside for now. We'll just have to fix our line here. go do a head roll here. See, I'm getting as bad as the helper there, wandering all over the place. FTL Mods also came out with a update for the Oliver Super 88. There's just one minor warning on it that he fixed. You guys can find this in the Oliver Super 88 at Okay Use Mods and J&M Farms on Facebook. Try to remember to include the link for that. He also tried to make the fuel consumption more realistic. So far we actually used 5% of the fuel, we're at 95%. Just able to pull this up the hill. I think we got it. Lantern matched up pretty good with the Oliver here for horsepower. I think we'll finish up by doing some more chisel plowing here. Also forgot to mention that Grandpa, my dad's dad, didn't have a Minneapolis-Moline nearly this big, but back in the day it was actually the biggest tractor in the area. Which is about 100 horsepower. I gotta find out which exact model that was. Alright guys, I think that's going to have to do it for this time. Hope you enjoyed the new tractors. Thanks for watching, everybody, and we will see you next time.